I'm going to take a deeper look at understanding the QnA feature in Oracle Intelligent Bots. Welcome back, my name is Grant Ronald from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. Now, I've talked about how a user phrase could be resolved to an intent or a QnA, or in fact both, but how does this process actually work? Now, intent resolution is based on understanding the meaning of whole sentences, where QnA is more about matching words as tokens. Now, since there are two ways of resolving user input, there are two separate models, and not surprisingly, each model has a different way of establishing the success of a match. So let's take a look at this in a little more detail. So we know that an input phrase is sent to the two models in parallel. The models will digest that phrase and then spit out a result. For the intent model, the output will be a confidence probability between 0 and 1. If the probability is above the confidence threshold, which is a property in the dialog flow, then the bot will assume an intent match. QnA model, on the other hand, uses something called a QnA minimum match within the dialog flow, which defines how many tokens or words should match in a QnA. So let's briefly look at the different combinations. Firstly, let's look at the case where an input phrase has been resolved above the confidence threshold, but the QnA model does not resolve it above the QnA minimum match. In this case, we simply show an intent. Now let's consider the case where the input matches both an intent and a QnA, in which case additional logic is used to establish if this is more likely to be an intent. The bot will check to see if the input phrase uses an imperative verb. Basically, this means, does the sentence look like it's a command? So verbs such as cancel, order, transfer are imperative and suggest this phrase is more likely to be an intent. And in which case, the intent is fired. And just for reference, the QnA features of Intelligent Bot is pre-configured with these imperative verbs, although you can add and remove verbs from this list should you wish to. If an imperative verb is not detected, the bot will present both options to the user. There is, however, one other check where both intent and QA are possibilities, and this is controlled by the dialog flow property QnA skip if intent found. If this is set to true, then what it means is that in the case of an input resolving to both an intent and a QnA, then the intent always wins, or saying it a different way, QnA is ignored. And of course, if an input phrase is not resolved to an intent, but only to a QnA, then the QnA is shown. And finally, if none of the models find a match, then it's simply unresolved. Now, there are a couple of more advanced features of a QnA that help you tweak the searches. So for example, you can define ignored words, words that you don't want to be matched. Now these would typically be words that help structure sentences but add little in terms of searching. For example, conjunctives such as and, but, or prepositions such as to, at, in, or on. You might even choose to ignore words such as proper nouns such as company names, since that appears in many different Q&As and adds no real value to the search. You can also add synonyms, so if your Q&A is structured to always talk about a spouse, but the user asks a question about a wife or a husband, then it makes sense that wife and husband can be matched to articles containing the word spouse. You can also add to the predefined list of words that indicate whether a user input sentence is likely to be related to an intent because of the use of an imperative verb. And you can read a bit more about these finer details in the documentation. So there you go, the Q&A feature of Oracle Intelligent Bot, a key use case for bots. Thank you very much for watching.